So let's have a programming exercise with the CUB library. Here's a simple example of the CUB block scan primitive, okay? And this is doing a prefix sum in a single block. And you've seen scan a lot by now. You know a lot of the intricacies of how it can be implemented. And so here's an example of how easy this is to implement with high performance in the IDE. And there's a couple different things about this from some of the examples you've seen. Again, we're focusing on a single block because the whole point of CUB is to give you intra-block primitives, code for writing your own thread block level code within CUDA kernels. So we're just going to time a single block, and we're going to measure something we haven't quite seen before. We're actually going to measure the scan throughput, and we're measuring that in clocks per element scanned. These are SM clocks, how many actual clock cycles the SM took averaged across the total number of elements that were scanned by this single thread block. You'll see the CUDA built-in clock in this kernel, and the way it's used is obvious. And what I want you to do is fill out this matrix. This is a performance matrix where we have the number of threads per block, which is represented in the code with block threads, and the number of items processed per thread, which is represented in the code with items per thread. And I want you to go ahead and look at the matrix here and experiment with different values of block threads and items per thread and try to figure out how these two items affect the scan throughput. It would be too much work to fill out this whole matrix, so let me just guide you to a few sweet spots. So much of the interesting action is going to happen along this diagonal. So for example, 1024 threads, each representing a single item, each in charge of scanning a single item per thread, is the kind of thing you might code up naturally. It might be the first thing you try. It's the simplest to code up. And then try to analyze what happens when you do 512 by 2 threads, 256 by 4 threads, 128 by 8 threads, and then let's go ahead and complete the diagonal. Won't take long at all. All the way down to 32 threads each responsible for 32 items, and 16 threads each responsible for 64 items. And so what I'm going to have you do is fill in this diagonal, and from the choices along this diagonal, check off the option that gives you the best performance. In other words, the highest scan throughput, which corresponds to the fewest clocks per element scanned.